This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Saint Malachy Middle Irish, Maol Maidhach Ua Morgair, Modern Irish, Maol Maidhach O Morgair 1095. Viking raids on Ireland began around the start of the 9th century. The country was subsequently invaded and occupied, many monasteries were plundered, monks were put to the sword, churches were demolished, and libraries were burned. These disruptions, along with secular impositions by the invaders, produced a decline in Christian religious observance and moral standards established by Saint Patrick and other early missionaries. Apathy towards the Christian virtues increased, and by the 11th century some parts of Ireland had even returned to paganism. Life Malachy, whose family name was Ua Morgair, was born in Armagh in 1095. Saint Bernard describes him as having noble birth. He was baptized Maol Maidhach Malachy and was trained under Imhar O'Hagan. Subsequently abbot of Armagh, Imhar was in sympathy with the aims of those who sought to reform the Irish Church, and it was probably through his influence that Malachy became imbued with their principles. After a long course of studies, Malachy was ordained priest by Saint Sulach Celsus in 1119. Shortly afterwards Sulach made the young priest his vicar for the next year or two. It was Malachy's duty to administer the Diocese of Armagh. He established in all the churches the apostolic sanctions and the decrees of the Holy Fathers, and the customs and practices of the Roman Church. He introduced the Roman method of chanting the services of the canonical hours and instituted a new confession, confirmation, the marriage contract, which those over whom he was placed were either ignorant or negligent. With the consent of Sulach and Imar, he went to study under Saint Malchus, who had by this time retired from the Archbishopric of Cashel and was settled at Lismore. He spent 3 years there abbot of Bangor in 1123. The Corb of Bangor Abbey died. Bangor was the principal religious site in the northeast of Ireland. Since he ended his days at Lismore, it may be assumed that he was a friend of Malchus, and of the movement with which he was identified. His successor, who was Malachy's uncle, expressed his willingness to surrender his office and the site of the monastery to his nephew. Malachy became abbot of Bangor Abbey. This became an opportunity to implement one of the canons of the Synod of Rathbersale, which by establishing the Diocese of Conor Sulach, as Corb of Patrick, and consecrated bishop, had been able to organize the Diocese of Armagh in accordance with the Rathbersale plan with the prestige which belonged to the Corb of Comgall. Malachy, if consecrated bishop, could probably succeed in organizing the Diocese of Conor in 1124. Malachy journeyed to Bangor, was installed as abbot, and was made bishop by Sulach in 1132. He was promoted to the primacy of Armagh. Saint Bernard provides many interesting anecdotes regarding Saint Malachy and highly praises Malachy's zeal for religion both in Conor and Armagh. In 1127, Malachy paid a second visit to Lismore and acted for a time as confessor to Cormac McCarthy, Prince of Desmond, while Bishop of Down and Conor. Malachy continued to reside at Bangor, and when some of the native princes sacked the two dioceses of Down and Conor, Malachy brought the Bangor monks to Avera, County Kerry, where they were welcomed by now King Cormac on the death of Saint Celsus, who was buried at Lismore in 1129. Saint Malachy was appointed Archbishop of Armagh, 1132, which dignity he accepted with great reluctance owing to intrigues. He was unable to take possession of his see for 2 years. Even then he had to purchase the Bachel Isu Staff of Jesus from Niall, the usurping lay primate. Saint Malachy's influence in Irish ecclesiastical affairs has been compared with that of Boniface in Germany during 3 years at Armagh. As Bernard of Clairvaux writes, Saint Malachy restored the discipline of the Church, grown lax during the intruded rule of a series of lay abbots, and had the Roman liturgy adopted. Saint Malachy worked zealously to restore ecclesiastical discipline, restored marriage, renewed the practices of confession and confirmation, and introduced Roman chants in the liturgy. He was also known for his care to the needy as a miracle worker and healer in his lifetime. He planted apple trees throughout Ireland during time of famine. Saint Bernard continues, having extirpated barbarism and re-established Christian morals, and seeing all things tranquil, Saint Malachy began to think of his own peace. He therefore resigned the sees of Armagh and Conor, in 1136 or 1137, but retained as Bishop of Down. He founded a priory of Austin canons at Downpatrick, and was unceasing in his episcopal labours. Early in 1139 he journeyed to Rome, via Scotland, England, and France. Visiting Saint Bernard at Clairvaux, he petitioned Pope Innocent II for pallia for the sees of Armagh and Cashel, and was appointed legate for Ireland on his return return visit to Clairvaux he obtained 5 monks for a foundation in Ireland, under Christian, an Irishman, as superior. Thus arose the great Abbey of Mellifont in 1142. Saint Malachy set out on a second journey to Rome in 1148, but on arriving at Clairvaux, he fell sick and died in the arms of Saint Bernard. On 2 November 1148 Veneration Saint Malachy canonized 1190 by Pope Clement III. Feast 3 November Patronage Archdiocese of Armagh, Diocese of Down and Connor. In the book Life of Saint Malachy, his biographer Saint Bernard of Clairvaux says Malachy was distinguished by his meekness, humility, obedience, modesty, and true diligence in his studies. Saint Charles Borromeo praised Saint Malachy for attending to the needy, bringing the holy sacraments to all alike, and renewing the fervor of the people in receiving them. Saint Malachy's feast is celebrated on 3 November, so as not to clash with All Souls' Day relics. Saint Malachy's body remained at Clairvaux Abbey and eventually was placed in a tomb near Bernard of Clairvaux. After the abbot's own death, the tomb was moved several times with the rebuilding of the church. Portions of his remains were sent to Ireland in 1194 and deposited at Mellifont Abbey and other abbeys of the Cistercians at some point at Clairvaux. Part of Malachy's arm and part of his skull were removed and placed in special reliquaries in the abbey's treasury. His arm was kept in a silver case decorated with precious stones. A portion of his skull was kept in a bust reliquary of gilt silver, also decorated with precious stones and topped by a mitre. These reliquaries may have been enameled or painted during the French Revolution. The reliquaries themselves were destroyed, although the relics were preserved. Malachy's head is now preserved in a reliquary in the treasury of Troyes Cathedral, not far from the site of Clairvaux. The tombs of the two friends and saints were destroyed in the aftermath of the Revolution, and the bones were commingled and distributed to various parishes in the district of Clairvaux. P.H. Guignard published an account of the relics in the Patrologia Latina. Patronage Malachy is patron saint of the Archdiocese of Armagh and the Diocese of Down and Connor. The Dominican Abbey at Carlingford S. 1305 was dedicated to him. Saint Malachy's Church, Belfast was intended to be the Cathedral Church of Down and Connor, dedicated in honour of the diocesan patron. However, the Irish famine broke out and the grand plans for the St. Malachy's Cathedral were shelved to divert funds to the needy. A number of parishes are dedicated to St. Malachy, including those in Brownsburg, Indiana, Burlington, Massachusetts, Kennedy Township, New York City, the Actors' Chapel, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Geneseo, Illinois, and Rantoul, Illinois. Prophecy of the Pope's main article, Prophecy of the Pope's A Prophecy of the Popes, is attributed to St. Malachy, which is claimed to predict that there would be only 112 more popes before the Last Judgment. Benedictine Arnold de Wyon discovered and published the so-called Doomsday Prophecy in 1590. Most scholars consider the document a 16th-century elaborate hoax. James Weiss, a professor of church history at Boston College, has stated, "It is widely thought, given who the author was and his relationship, were published to establish the case for election of one particular cardinal, Thomas Groome, chair of the Department of Religious Education and Pastoral Ministry at Boston College, has a similar notion. For myself, and even as a native Irishman, the prophecies of St. Malachy are a grand old fun tale that have about as much reliability as the morning horoscope." Thomas J. Rees, S.J., of Georgetown University, had only this to say: St. Malachy's prophecy is nonsense. In popular culture, St. Malachy, his doomsday prophecy, and the conflicts between the Christians and pagans are important plot points in James Rollins' sixth Sigma Force novel, The Doomsday Key, 2009, particularly in Chapter 21. See also Biography, Portal, Catholicism, Portal Saints, Portal Ireland, Portal Vaticinia Nostradami, St. Malachy's Church, Belfast. Prophecy of the Popes references A.B. Who is St. Malachy? St. Malachy org St. Malachy Parish, Burlington, Massachusetts. Doomsday Prophecy, Discovery News. Luke Netterville, Donatus Ofadabra, Albert Suerbier, Reginald of Bologna, Abraham O'Connellane, Mael Patraic, Ua Scanale, Nicol Mac, Mael Isu, John Taffa, Walter Jors, Roland Jors, Stephen Seagrave, David Mag Eructai, Richard Fitzrafe, Milo Sweetman, John Colton, Nicholas Fleming, John Swain, John Preen, John May, John Bull, John Foxalls, Edmund Consberg, Ottaviano Spinelli de Palacio, John Kite, George Cromer. Authority Control WorldCat Identities VIAF, 21,079,230 LCCN, N8406805-6 ISNI, 0000-0001-1043-6631 GND, 118,576,631 Sudik, 0273560463.